I'm eating an apple. You go get one, too. And while you're eating it, I'll tell you a true story about apples and about a famous hero of the Old West. His name was Johnny Appleseed. He was a funny kind of a hero. He never rode in a covered wagon. He never had a gunfight with an outlaw. And he never fought any Indians. What Johnny Appleseed did was plant apple trees. Thousands and thousands of apple trees all over the West.
There was one hero in the West who never owned a gun. His name was Johnny Appleseed. He was loved by everyone. He spent his time planting apple seeds so every girl and boy and man and woman in the West would have apples to enjoy. He planted apple seeds everywhere. He planted them for all to share. He was a friend in time of need. His name was Johnny Appleseed. Now Johnny's coat was a sugar sack. His feet were always bare. And Johnny's hat was an old tin pot. And he never combed his hair. He never feared a single thing. But he never heard a fly. Birds would sing their song for him as he went walking by. He planted apple seeds everywhere. He planted them for all to share. He was a friend in time of need. His name was Johnny Appleseed.
When Johnny Appleseed traveled around, he didn't go in a big truck. Or in a freight train. They didn't have them in those days. Sometimes Johnny traveled in a canoe with his apple seeds in big deerskin bags. Sometimes he went on horseback with the apple seeds in his saddlebags. But mostly, he walked with the apple seeds in a leather bag on his back. He went around to plant his apple trees in all kinds of weather. When it was nice, when it was stormy, and even when it was snowing. Oh, it was quite a sight seeing Johnny Appleseed walking through the woods with his long hair and beard and always with the good book under his arm. All he ever wore for clothes was a sugar sack with holes cut out for his arms and legs. And his hat was nothing but the tin pot he used to cook his food in. And you know something? He never wore shoes. He walked in his bare feet, even in the wintertime. Johnny certainly was a funny sight. But the funniest thing of all was that nobody ever laughed at him. He was so kind to everyone that they all loved Johnny Appleseed and were always very happy to see him coming.
Here comes Johnny Appleseed.
Hello, Johnny Appleseed.
Hooray for Johnny Appleseed!
Appleseed, Appleseed,
we like you.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
yes we do.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
you're okay.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
hip hip hooray!
Hooray, Johnny Appleseed, hooray! You
have come to town today, and we wish that you would stay, but you'll soon be on your way.
Yes, Johnny, Johnny Appleseed.
Hello, Johnny Appleseed, hello. You're the finest man we know. Trees that grow every single place you go.
Yes, Johnny, Johnny Appleseed.
Here's a cheer, Johnny Appleseed, a cheer. We are glad that you are here, and we wish you stay a year. When you leave, we'll shed a tear.
Yes, Johnny Appleseed.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
we like you.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
yes we do.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
you're okay.
Appleseed, Appleseed,
hip hip hooray.
People used to ask Johnny Appleseed, Johnny, why do you go around planting all those apple trees? And Johnny would tell them,
well, when I was a boy back in Massachusetts, I loved apples more than anything else. Everybody I knew loved apples. All the neighbors had apple trees in their backyards. Why, I can remember how happy the people were eating apples. Some took little bites so they'd last longer. Some took big bites because they tasted so good. Some ate them slow. Some ate them fast. But no matter how they ate them, everybody loved apples. Then one day a man came to town from out the west, and he said,
you folks sure are mighty lucky to have these wonderful apples growing right here in your own backyard. You know, we don't have any apples at all out west.
Well, when I heard that, I just couldn't believe it. A place just shouldn't be without apples. Why, how could the people be happy? So I thought about it for a long time. And then when I grew up, I knew just what I wanted to do. I would plant enough apple trees so that everybody in the West would have one right in his own backyard.
Yep, and he did. All through Ohio and Indiana, as far south as Tennessee, and as far west as the Rocky Mountains, Johnny planted apple trees. And those apples were the start of the apples that we have today. Macintosh apples, Delicious apples, Cortland apples, Jonathan apples, Baldwin and Winesap apples, Rome apples, Golden and Star apples.
Apples, apples, apples are fun to eat. Apples, apples, apples are a great big treat. Cortland and Jonathan and, by gosh, Golden, Delicious and Macintosh. Apples, apples, apples are nice to munch at breakfast time or supper and for lunch. Winesap and Baldwin, Rome and Star, people like apples whoever they are.
Then there's apple strudel, applesauce, apple cake and apple pie, apple cider, apple juice, apple rings, and my oh my, apples baked and apples fried, apples on a stick for you, apple butter, apple jelly, scalloped apples, fritters too.
Apples, apples, apples are fun to eat. Apples, apples, apples are a great big treat. Cortland and Jonathan and, by gosh, Golden, Delicious and Macintosh. Apples, apples, apples are nice to munch at breakfast time or supper and for lunch. wine sap and whirlwind, Roman star. People like apples, whoever they are. Apples, apples, apples are a great big treat. Cortland and Jonathan and, by gosh, Golden, Delicious and Macintosh. Oh, apples, apples, apples are nice to munch at breakfast time or supper and for lunch. Wine sap and ball wind roll.